Where is it?
Hey, what's up, guys? Today I'm hanging out with Sean Duras.
And some liquid nitrogen, no big deal.
See, a lot of you know that I replenished my recent supply of liquid nitrogen, and this stuff has a shelf life. So while we've got it, we're putting it to good use, and we're revisiting the nitrogen rocket project.
But with a twist, we got an idea. Rocket launcher!
What do you think? Can we make it work? We've never done this before. We really have no idea how it's gonna go.
It's gonna be amazing is what it's gonna be. What's the danger level of all this stuff? I feel like there's a lot of peer pressure in this video that's gonna go down.
If it touches your skin, just freak out like it's a spider and you'll be okay. Yeah, right in the middle of the road. That's awesome.
Perfect.
That's not conspicuous at all. Pick up that big tank, and that stuff is extremely expensive, so don't spill any.
We just have two problems. Problem number one, I'm scared of liquid nitrogen. Problem number two, I don't have big muscles to lift this thing.
Well, give it your best shot.
Okay, here we go.
Nobody's judging.
Oh boy.
Oh, dude, there's money. Oh,
whoops.
Wow. You see it like bubbling and spitting right out of the top?
That's insane. Alright.
Is this your first time with liquid nitrogen?
Oh no, I do this like every day, all day.
Alright, so we got our water bottle. You can see it's about half full of just regular tap water, room temperature, a little bit of liquid nitrogen. We don't have a whole lot of time to play with here, so let's get you going on this before that water freezes up. Oh shoot. Alright, just grab that bottle and flip it right upside down.
Upside down?
Yeah.
Whoa! What did you just do to me? Dude, rocket launcher, this is so doable now.
You see it? You see how this
yes.
is going? Next trip, Home Depot, we're gonna go pick up some materials and see if we can makeshift a rocket launcher out of this.
I mean, that was kind of cool, but imagine a rocket like...
There's our rocket bodies right there. These 500 milliliters have really durable plastic, so they work great.
You gotta get green. It's like Army rocket launcher green.
Yeah, I'm digging
right?
that.
Army missiles?
Let's get it. All right, so we just got back from Home Depot. We've got all our materials, and all we're using for this rocket launcher is a 4-inch piece of PVC pipe. We've also got these 4-inch couplings. These are ABS, and they're black, so we don't need to paint them. They look cool as is. These are gonna go on either end of the rocket launcher. And then Sean's idea was to use this for a handle, which is actually pretty cool. This is a 1/2-inch connector tee, and we're gonna just basically slice that off, bend the plastic, and meld it to the bottom so that we've got a built-in handle. Now it's gonna take a little bit of time for this to warm up because we don't want it to catch on fire and burn. So this could take a while, this could take a couple of minutes, but the key is just to be gentle and keep it moving.
It's worth it. The turtle wins the race.
Just joking. Look how rubbery that is.
Yeah.
Okay, so you just kind of hold that down, or why don't you go find a cloth or something?
Yeah.
We just want to hold this thing against that pipe and get the sides as flat as possible. The more surface area we can make contact with, the better the thing's gonna stick.
This is rocket science. This is rocket launcher science.
All right, there we go.
That's smooth.
Cool.
Shiny.
I think we're in business. All right, we got our little handle formed here. It fits pretty nicely. We just got to figure out what feels right for balance. I'm holding onto the back here by the coupling because that's where the rocket's going to enter. Right about there feels pretty awesome. So go ahead and mark that.
Oh, looks good.
Now it's time to glue it up, and for that we're going to need some ABS to PVC cement, like this stuff. And check this out.
The green goo gets
it's best. Green.
Delicious.
Really goo. It kind of looks like slime. You got to work it a little bit. While that's sitting, let's go work on making our rockets next. Now when it comes to making your rocket bodies, that's the kind of bottle you want to get. Something that's a 500 milliliter soda bottle because it's pressurated, and that'll be able to contain the liquid nitrogen as it's expanding rapidly. The thing about these soda bottles is they're really flat on the bottom, and so they're not aerodynamically stable. When they fly up into the air, they tumble and fall all over the place. So what we need to do is come up with some kind of a nose cone.
Cut this off, take the bottom part of this bottle, the top part of this bottle, put on the bottom part of here, and now we've got aerodynamic ammunition. I think that'll do.
How funny looking is that? Like, which end do I drink from?
It's a teamwork bottle.
Now the reason we got the 4-inch PVC tube is because these bottles, when you put them inside, you can see it leaves a little bit of a gap around the edges, and that's where we're gonna build our fins.
We've worked out some kind of a little fin template here that almost matches the bulge there. It doesn't have to be perfect because we're gonna use hot glue to fill in the gaps, and that should mesh together pretty well.
We're also gonna need to add a couple little nubs in here to balance the top end when it sits in the rocket as well.
Now we're gonna paint them rocket launchers because they need to look awesome.
Funny story, this is the actual spray paint I used when I built my rocket rifle 4 years ago, which was one of my first videos. Kind of sentimental.
What you're gonna wanna do here is just with gentle hands, go like that. Gentle hands though, you wanna keep those hands gentle. What you're gonna wanna do.
Now we just gotta go set this down for a few minutes and let it dry.
I will destroy you!
So I think I roughed in all the cardboard.
Where was I when you made this?
And I might have to trim these fins up a little bit. I think that's gonna be our rocket right there. I'm just gonna give it a hit of black spray paint to make it a little bit cooler.
Definitely do that. Yes. 100%. And maybe a little bit of green. Camouflage bullets, they won't see it coming.
Our rocket's pretty much done, painted black with some spray paint. And the cool thing about using a bottle top is that you can still unscrew it, and there's a cavity in here where you can add some weight. I'm just gonna put a little bit of sand in there, and that's gonna shift the center of gravity forward and make this thing a little more aerodynamic. So check it out, guys, our project is done. We've got some pretty cool looking equipment. We're ready to launch rockets.
Liquid nitrogen missiles, to be exact.
So if you wanna see how that turned out, go check out the Sean Duras channel. We're gonna be there getting ready to rocket.
Wait, did you say rocket?
Okay guys, we just got back from filming in the park and I cannot wait to show you the footage that we got. What you're gonna see on this guy's video,
we exploded and the missile went up and it went in the ground and made a hole like this big and tell him all that.
Now if you're wondering who Sean Duras is, I met him at CVX Live. He's a really cool guy.
No big deal, BFFs.
Tell these guys in about 5 seconds what you do on your
channel. 5 seconds, fun.
It's fun. So if you like daily vlogs and watching like random adventures, he's always getting in.
Lots of skateboarding, snowboarding, shredding, falling, getting hurt, awesomeness.
Alright, so go check them out, and thanks for joining us for this adventure. We're gonna see you guys in the next video with some other random project. I'll talk to you then.
It's good.